कुठली कळली तुम्हाला म्हणजे यू फाउंड आउट आयदर सिंक्रोनस मोटर्स असतात किंवा ब्रशलेस डी सी मोटर्स असतात. इथरमध्ये एस्पेशली ब्रशलेस डी सी मोटर आहे. एनिवेअर बिटवीन 7 kW to 10 kW मोटर्स असतात क्लासिकली या डिव्हायसेसमध्ये. अँड दे आर ऑल डी सी. सो प्रायमरिली यू विल फाइंड अ लॉट ऑफ डी सी टू डी सी कंट्रोल वुड बी रिक्वायर्ड. आणि एस्पेशली अ व्हेइकल लाईक एथर हॅज बेल्ट ट्रान्समिशन. अत्यंत घाणेरडा आवाज काढते एथर ज्यावेळेला बेल्ट लूज असेल त्यावेळेला. पण दॅट्स वन ऑफ द ट्रान्समिशन मेकॅनिझम दॅट इट हॅज. आणि घाणेरडा का म्हणतो कारण की आय हॅव ड्रिव्हन दॅट. घरी आहे एक एथर. इट्स वन ऑफ द वर्स्ट नॉईज मेकिंग वन्स ज्यावेळेला ते बेल्ट लूज होतो त्यावेळेला. सो डी सी टू डी सी पार्ट इज वॉट वी वर लुकिंग ॲट. सो वॉट एम गोन डू नाव इज फॉर द नेक्स्ट 15 मिनिट्स आय एम गोन शट माय माउथ अप आणि लेट सी हाऊ मेनी क्वेश्चन्स कम अप राईट नाव बेस्ड ऑन ऑल दॅट वी हॅव स्पोकन. And then we'll take it from there. So at least by 4 we can then start again. For a last part where I would want to actually design a simple drive for the EV. I also want to design a charging circuit for a EV. Right? So charging, which is again power electronics related part. Drive, which is again a power electronics related part. Let's at least get an idea how it is necessarily done. And I think I made some statements about complexities. I made some statements about some of the areas. We'll try and correlate them from a point of view because I have put forth my point of view. Maybe some of you have a different point of view. Jala avan counterpoint manto. We'll also look at the point and the counterpoint. Yes. Questions from your side. Mi khup vicharle magcha did tasat. Now it's your time to ask the questions. I don't claim that I will know all the answers, but I will try my best.
Now what is the scope, sir, in power reverse
gauge for EV? For research, for public research. If you don't mind, can I take the research part towards the end of my session? Because I'm going to talk about EV and research a bit separately. So I take your question in two parts. One is scope of power electronics and scope of research in the EV area. Power electronics, I'll honestly tell you, today I think many do not get into EV space, especially in the power area, because they don't know power electronics. A lot of power electronics is required in terms of understanding of high power devices, MOSFETs and IGBTs, which I think our engineers today do not know in terms of their operation. सो म्हणून मी जे सकाळी स्टेटमेंट केलं सरांकडे बघूनच केलं सर इंडस्ट्रियल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स शिकवतात आपला डिप्लोमा आहे जो इंडस्ट्रियल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स आहे. आय थिंक आय रिअली रिअली वॉन्ट दॅट डिव्हिजन टू बी देअर. म्हणजे तो बॅचलर्स कोर्सही यायला पाहिजे तर म्हणजे त्याला ईव्ही करा पाहिजे तर म्हणजे काहीतरी म्हणायचं चांगलं असतं ना त्याला ईव्ही म्हणा पण पॉवर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स शिकवा. म्हणजे आय रिअली सेईंग इट किंवा त्याला काहीतरी छान नाव द्यायला लागतं ना त्याच्याशिवाय लोकांना पटत नाही. इंडस्ट्री इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स म्हटलं ना की लोक रिपेअरमॅन वाटतात राईट बाकीच्या आर यू रिपेअर बॉईज ऑर गर्ल्स राईट. म्हणजे आमच्या वर्गात मुली नव्हत्याच त्यामुळे इंडस्ट्रियल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्समध्ये आणि कम्प्युटर्समध्ये मुली असतात म्हणायचं इंडस्ट्रियल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स कोणी भेटायचं नाही राईट. बट द पॉईंट आर ट्राइंग टू मेक इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स अँड पॉवर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इज एक्स्ट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हेन इट कम्स टू ईव्हीज. बिकॉज wherever there is power distribution and charging, because you need to ultimately distribute power. Distribution is not only just when it comes through transmission lines, it is also distributed within the vehicle. I have a point that comes in after that I convert and give it to battery packs. That is also my distribution circuit. All of that is power electronics. Supply the sarani tapalo. Namaskar sarani. Tyachyamadhye jar tumhi baghitla tar all those touch points actually are all related to high power and include power electronics. And unfortunately, our students can't even imagine today what it might be. So power electronics is extremely important. In fact, research in the EV space is booming like crazy right now in all areas. One thing which I'll tell you, I'll describe it a little later, but one thing which I'll tell you, EV matra research ha mezo bakto atta, mezo watch so, because I'm not a person who will read everything that comes in. My interest areas are classically in the charging space. So where I can build products as chargers. And the Maza interest is business interest model. The second interest, what I have is in terms of drives and controls, where my company works in that area. Now, those areas are there, there is a lot of research that is happening in terms of high-speed control, the CAN networks that are used, CAN FD networks that are used. People are talking about Ethernet, automotive Ethernet is what is being spoken about. So that area is big. So in terms of research, and basic sciences research, bharpur aata chalela, jachyamadhye battery capacity, quickest charging, chemistry, electronics, electrical as a battery, right? 10 minutes, how much you can pump in into the molecules, right? That we are looking at. So that area is big. But what my personal reading is, engineers may stay at electronics, power electronics or software, but when it comes to battery, I think battery chemistry is also getting a lot of importance in terms of what is the composition of the battery, how the battery is really made up of. And if I have to quickly compare, you may be able to appreciate this, ki, what kind of fuel are we talking about, right? The amount of octane I'm talking about, the whole system changes, right, in terms of the chemistry of the system, right? Chemistry in the system changes in terms of fuel type, right? Fuel type. So similarly is the case for battery, and that area is very rich in allowing us to do a good amount of deeper research along with petrol systems. Right, it's a very rich area. And if there is an industrial electronics at the lab, that lab into doing this kind of research would be amazing. And one more piece is, we are talking about EVs, right? But for me, while I say that EV is not a mobile phone with wheels, but EVs are drones are EVs. Right? Drones are also EVs, basically. They are flying machines. Right? So drones become EVs. There are a lot of amphibian machines, right, which go deep sea, which do diving into the sea and also explore the seabeds. Not deep, but at least coral reefs or the shallow waters, but they do these explorations. Those are all actually EVs which are propelling into the water. So, propelling factor of an EV. Any EV, but a propelling factor. Propelling in air, propelling on land, and propelling in water. All three will comprise of it. So, let us not limit ourselves, even if I am talking about it, only two-wheeler, four-wheeler and trucks. They are below the waters, they are inside the waters, and they are also above the ground, basically. So those are also some of the opportunities that we have in terms of research as well. I won't say research is not happening, but not as much. But I believe the number of ideas that I get out of even these type of gatherings, that 10% that you have research one put in, if we take that forward, I strongly believe we'll be able to get a lot of not only research papers but a lot of knowledge out. So research tremendous potential in these areas. Okay. So we have to go beyond two-wheelers and four-wheelers. Let's go beyond two-wheelers and four-wheelers. Manut, the power electronics as an area, interdisciplinary as an area, is much required. In fact, tomorrow if you start kitchen equipment running on rechargeable DC equipment in say a restaurant kitchen, I strongly believe it will be as good as a EV, because the mixers and the grinders are all actually operating on a moving parts. Chutney karta to ragda asto, the idli dough that is prepared, so that is also requires the same kind of equipment. Of course, I don't want to stretch our imagination. EVs is electric vehicles, it will stick to on land, inside, water, and above the water. Yes, sir. Long answer, but I hope it's clear. So, what research we are doing currently, in 2024, we have got two funded research in my own company where we are doing research on high speed communication networks, which is one interest area that we have specifically for EVs. And second thing that we are doing is on the controls and diagnostics for the power electronics and the entire power grid, the power grid. So those are the two areas that we ourselves are actually working on in terms of research. Because in that area, onboard diagnostics and CAN, which are protocols, they are not defined. Manufacturers are defining their own proprietary protocols. And that itself is a very rich area to get into. Standardization will come over it, but at least if you work on some common base, which can be a contribution into the research world and the industry. Yes. Yes, sir. I consider EV with multiple hearts, but yes, I agree.
One heart is motor.
Yes.
Was
what we are in the morning is 50% of energy is still generated using the thermal plants. So effectively we are running our vehicles on the coal itself. So first of all, what we are doing is we are converting the coal into energy and then again energy into the vehicle. That transmission losses and conversion losses are all again higher up in the.
Absolutely. So first, I think you are right. Today, if we look at it in India, a lot of electricity is generated by burning coal, thermal. So we are just displacing pollution from one place to the other. म्हणजे आता सांगलीतला जो पोल्युटिंग पार्क आहे इथे जर आपण ईव्हीज आणल्या सिटी बसेस तर आपण काय करू इथलं पोल्युशन कमी झालं पण जिथून इलेक्ट्रिसिटी घेतोय तिथे पोल्युशन होणार आहे सो वी हॅव जस्ट चेंज द प्लेस ऑफ पोल्युशन म्हणजे वी हॅव डिस्ट्रीब्युटेड द प्रॉब्लेम इव्हन ऑफ पोल्युशन सो जोपर्यंत I may become old school, but whatever I have read and little that I understand in the nuclear power, I would really prefer nuclear power. Because nuclear power has still proven for decades that it is the cleanest power that we can get. And of course, it requires tremendous amount of management in terms of nuclear power plants. But that seems to be one area to look at. Thermal, even solar is too, solar requires too much infrastructure to harness the amount of power that we harness today. The amount of square foot that we need to harness that much amount of power is very high for solar. And the solar, for an individual, solar is power. But for a nation, solar is a hobby. Because you're not generating that much, right? Amount of space that you need. But is it a bad thing to go behind solar? No, solar is good. But the ecosystem value is key. Itlari. But otherwise, we are actually just probably displacing pollution from one place to the other. But why we say